Fibrocystic breast disease, like fibroids, as well as PMS and menstrual irregularities, are all part of the continuum of estrogen excess in the body. Fibrocystic breast disease tend to be one of the first symptoms of estrogen dominance, and it can affect women in even in their teenage years. This is Dr. Lam, founder of drlam.com. In this video, as well as in my article in my website on this very topic called estrogen dominance, explain the phenomenon of fibrocystic breast disease and its significance. Let's take a step back. When the body is growing, estrogen is necessary. It is oftentimes balanced with progesterone. When estrogen is in excess, then it flows into various tissues, including the breast, and fibrocystic breast disease becomes a symptom. The breast feels enlarged. It can often become rocky. And on ultrasound and palpation, you can have multiple cysts. And this can be very uncomfortable. These cysts can oftentimes be made worse during the menstrual cycle. In severe cases, the estrogen not only causes the cyst to grow, but it also goes to other places of the body, including the uterus, leading to endometriosis, as well as ultimately cancer. So fibrocystic breast disease is one of the most early signs of a body in hormonal imbalance. But most people, conventional doctors especially, will tend to resolve this with the use of birth control pills. There are good things to this, but at the same time, it really suppresses the symptoms and does not address the real underlying root cause of fibrocystic breast disease. Now, I urge you, if you have this type of symptoms, to, of course, check with your doctor to make sure that everything is fine. But if you have other symptoms, including things like water retention, irritability, brain fog, as well as period pain and heavy bleeding, you have to think that what is really going on that causes the body to behave like this. These are not abnormal behaviors. These are behaviors that the body is trying to send you a message. And the message is, do not put more estrogen in the system. Now, estrogen is widely and abundantly in the society available. They come from our food, from hormones, laced meat that goes into our body. They are present in xenoestrogenic compounds that look like estrogen, and they are present in things like shampoo, as well as plastic containers. So there's a lot of places where we get estrogen. Same thing as well as with stress, because the stress will ask the adrenal glands to put up more progesterone, which is then shunted to make cortisol. It also makes more estrogen. Lastly, if you have a weight problem with overweight, then the increase in adipose tissue also increase estrogen, and increased estrogen can lead to fibrocystic breast disease. So look at fibrocystic breast disease as a symptom. My article called Estrogen Dominance in my website will go through with you, as well as the one called Progesterone, that give you a good view. And then based on that, you will understand how to deal with this, how to recognize it as a symptom, and how to really make sense out of this whole situation. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I've written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.